You little bastards. That's good though. We thought we'd do one more song since that was so much fucking fun. I trust you're all knackered like me, but I reckon for 3.5 minutes we can lose our minds one more time. What do you say? Sick. This is gonna be sick. So everyone, this is the rule. If you stand still, you're a fucking dickhead. This song's called Throne.
Jordan a question. Come here.
Jordan.
This is Jordan. My question for you is, I follow this band for so many years. And when you became a part of it, I put myself in your shoes and I became very nervous and I got a stomach ache. But you have created a sound that has driven this band to a certain point, which is unbelievable. But my question is, I don't know how your psyche works. Did you have any like trepidation and nerves early on? Not in 2019, but when you first started out.
I have nerves all the time, so yeah, I'm a nervous person. Yes.
So not just then, but before a show tonight, you feel a little butterfly?
Every time, yeah. I'm drunk, actually.
You're playing a show here in front of such an intimate crowd.
Good job, Jordan!
What do you remember about your early shows just in music playing to small crowds?
I had no idea you were going to make me do this in front of all these people. Really embarrassing. What was the question?
Just playing to a very intimate crowd when we can see everybody's eyeballs and the sweat on their forehead. Oh, here's your bandmates!
I think that's the first time. It's been a while since we've had people on stage with us, so that was cool.
Hello.
Yeah, that was
Hello.
A nice vibe. That was Hello. One of the best shows
it's all eyes.
Of the time, actually. That was
cool. Really?
Yeah.
Oh, nice, nice! Ollie, it's a similar question to Jordan. This venue here, and you can see everybody right here, but I want to go back to early shows. When you were first starting out, was it just family members going? How the hell did you get people to the show? And what were those shows like super early on?
The first show we ever played was a vegan all-day festival in Manchester. Apart from that, though, that's not as funny. There was one person there, and Lee's mom. All our moms were there, weren't they, actually? Lee's mom were.
Our parents
herself.
Used to drive us to the show.
Yeah.
Because we weren't old.
All our moms were beside themselves. They just thought,
yeah.
Waste of time.
Yeah. It's a phase.
So next month, my math is not great. I shouldn't do math. But next month makes 15 years exactly since you guys formed as a band. 15 years. Does it feel like 15 years? Has it flown by? Do you feel like you are where you should be right now?
Our joints feel like it's been 15 years, don't they? Feel right old, right old. Is anyone else 32 here? It's horrible, isn't it? That's it.
Clearly, I think everyone knows this, and people that follow you, I think we all admire how you have a path as a group that you want to stick to, and it doesn't matter what the outside noise says that you should do. Right?
The Noid's always telling us to back down, but... No, I mean, we don't really know what we're doing. Honestly, like, we never have a clear goal of what we're doing. We just, like, we make an album, and then the next time we go, we want to do it all different, and that's the only thing we ever say, is let's just do something completely different. We never have an angle. We're never like, let's get bigger. Let's get more mainstream. Mainstream? we're all doing it tonight, aren't we?
That's right.
I forgot what I'm about.
And
yeah, we just try our best. Like when we started this band, none of us, apart from Lee, could play their instruments. We just made loads of noise, and people kept telling us we're shit, so we tried to get a bit better. And we still do that. But this is the band we want to be. Honestly, this is the band we want to be. There's no big goal. We've never had a goal. You know, some people come up to us and go, "So what were your business plan? How did you make it? How did you do this? How did you get so big?" And we're like, we never did anything but just try and make music that we liked to listen to, and that's the only thing you do.
Excellent. And you know what? On that note, you have a show tomorrow at the Forum. You played Kimmel tonight. You played here at our HD
Still
Radio
tickets on the door.
Space.
Still tickets on the door.
What's that?
Still tickets on the door.
Very few.
Is anyone coming tomorrow? Is anyone not? You bastard. After that performance, come on. It's only about $20. No, yeah. We're playing tomorrow, so if you want to come see us, it's going to be better.
What is the first thing you do? So you're gonna leave here, you're gonna go to the hotel room. Is it order food? Is it sleep? Is it hit like the cashews at the mini bar? Like,
cashews are gone.
Cashews are gone?
Yeah, them last night, yeah. They got eaten last night.
The bit of Friends on Netflix. You know they have all 10 seasons, don't you? She does. So I'm on season 10, episode 14, nearly at the end. I'll start again, probably tonight, and then drift off.
All right. Well, you guys, did you have a good time? Yeah! KROQ and the HD Radio Sound Space, we appreciate you so much.
Cheers for having us.
For
we appreciate the support. Thank you very much for having us.
Bring me the horizon, everybody. Give it.